Hello students, I am Sachitrakar. Welcome to Cars Physics. This is my lecture 7 on kinematics and we are continuing motion in a straight line. In this lecture, we will discuss some numericals based on acceleration. Okay? And as we know, acceleration is defined as rate of change of velocity. And again, acceleration can be expressed change in velocity with respect to change in time or change in velocity with respect to change in displacement. Okay, then acceleration is of four types: uniform acceleration or constant acceleration, non-uniform acceleration or variable acceleration, then average acceleration, and finally instantaneous acceleration. Okay, in this lecture we will solve numericals based on these four types of acceleration, and also we will see how acceleration may be calculated taking change in velocity with respect to change in time, or acceleration can be calculated by using change in velocity with respect to change in displacement. Okay, so in this lecture we will discuss some fundamental numericals and also some numericals based on application. Okay, and those application based numericals will help you for your future competitive, okay, like NEET and JEE, etc. Okay, let's start this lecture. Question number one: a body moves along east with a velocity of 30 meter per second, changes its direction in 10 seconds and moves along north with a velocity 40 meter per second, then we have to find what is acceleration of the body. Okay, this is most easier question, and here we will use acceleration is defined as rate of change of velocity, and change in velocity means final velocity minus initial velocity. Since velocity is vector quantity, we have to use the method of vector subtraction. Okay, this much only. We'll use vector subtraction and we'll find acceleration taking change in velocity with respect to change in time. Okay, then here acceleration is change in velocity means final velocity minus initial velocity divided by change in time. Okay, so this is the case of vector subtraction: v2 vector plus minus v1 vector divided by change in time. As we know, the method of vector subtraction is equivalent to method of vector subtraction is equivalent to the method of vector addition, only negative of one vector is added with other vector. V2 minus v1 is same as that of v2 plus minus v1. Means here direction of initial velocity v1 is reversed and added with final velocity v2. Okay, then initial velocity is along east. Let this velocity is v1, direction is towards east. The body changes its direction towards north. Okay, this is final velocity along north. This is directed along north. Okay, then as we see direction of initial velocity along east, direction of final velocity along north, and angle between initial and final velocity is theta, that's equals to 90 degree. Then to get acceleration, we have to get magnitude of v2, magnitude of acceleration, magnitude of change in velocity divided by change in time. So this may be written as delta v, magnitude of delta v divided by delta t. Then we have to find the magnitude of v2 vector minus v1 vector, or magnitude of delta v, which is resultant of v2 minus v1. Okay, then as per the method, v2 minus v1 is equal to v2 plus minus v1, means direction of initial velocity is reversed. Okay, so initial direction is towards east. If we reverse the direction, then this will be the direction, means towards west. So this is minus V1. Then we have torque minus V1 with V2. Now you may apply parallelogram law of vector addition. Okay. V2 plus minus V1. So now let's complete parallelogram. This is a diagonal passing through the intersection of the vectors. So this is the resultant means delta V. Okay. So magnitude of delta V or magnitude of V2 vector minus V1 vector as per the law of vector subtraction, square root of V2 square plus V1 square plus 2V1 V2 cos 180 degree minus theta. Okay. Then magnitude of change in velocity, square root of V2 square, final velocity is 40 meter per second. V1 square, initial velocity is 30 meter per second. Okay, then 2V1 V2 cos 180 minus theta, here theta is 90 degree, cos 180 minus 90 means cos 90 is 0, 0 into 2V1 V2 is 0. So magnitude of change in velocity, square root of V2 square plus V1 square, and we will get magnitude of change in velocity is 50 meter per second. Now magnitude of acceleration, magnitude of change in velocity divided by change in time. Change in velocity is 50 meter per second. Change in time, time taken by the body is 10 seconds. So finally it comes 5 meter per second square. And accordingly you can calculate direction of acceleration. So in vector form we may write acceleration is delta V by delta T. Direction of acceleration is along the direction of change in velocity or delta V. Let change in velocity means delta V makes an angle alpha with V1, means direction of V1 is reversed. Then we can calculate alpha. See, length of line represents magnitude of vector. This length of line represents magnitude of V2. So this length is equal to this length. This length also represents magnitude of V2, and this length represents magnitude of V1. So we may use here tan alpha. Okay, tan alpha. This angle is 90 degree, tan alpha is perpendicular divided by base. Perpendicular represents magnitude of V2, base represents magnitude of V1. So this comes, V2 is 40 meter per second, V1 is 30 meter per second. So this is 4 by 3. So obviously alpha is, tan alpha is 4 by 3. So alpha is 53 degree. Okay, so this is about direction of acceleration, and magnitude is 5 meter per second square. Okay, then question number 2. Okay, question number 2. Velocity of a body changes from, let the initial velocity is V1, changes from V1 is equal to 2 I cap plus 3 J cap meter per second to final velocity, let V2, 2 I cap minus 3 J cap meter per second in, let, you may take any interval of time, let in 2 seconds. Okay, find acceleration of the body. Okay, then here V1 and V2 are given. Then the question shows that the motion of the body is on a plane, means on XY plane. I cap direction, direction of I cap is along X axis, direction of J cap is along Y axis. So motion is on the plane of XY or XY plane. Okay, then acceleration is change in velocity V2 minus V1 divided by change in time delta T V2. V2 is 2 I cap minus 3 J cap minus V1 2 I cap plus 3 J cap divided by interval of time. Here interval of time delta T is 2 seconds. So acceleration is 2 I cap minus 2 I cap 0 minus 3 J cap minus 3 J cap means minus 6 J cap divided by 2 means acceleration is minus 3 J cap. Okay, so magnitude of acceleration is 3 meter per second square. Okay, and in vector form we may write 3 into minus j cap. Okay, so direction of acceleration is along minus j cap, means the direction of acceleration is along negative y axis. Okay, is it clear to you? Very easy questions. Okay, then question number 3. You are taking screenshot, you should take. Okay, question number 3 is a fundamental question. The aim of question number 3 is, after solving this, you can estimate the nature of motion when you go through the similar types of numericals. Okay, displacement S related with time t, as in BT it is given, relation between displacement and time, displacement directly proportional to time bit b, displacement directly proportional to square of time bit c, displacement directly proportional to cube of time. State nature of motion. Okay, suppose displacement of a body is s, instantaneous time means any time is t. Okay, displacement and time are related as given in question. Okay, in 3 bits we have to answer the nature of motion in 3 cases. First case, displacement proportional to time, so displacement is equal to a constant into time. Okay, since time changes always, time always increases, so there must be velocity. Okay, time changes, so displacement changes, so acceleration is produced, then velocity is produced, then velocity is ds by dt, that's equals to d by dt, in place of s we can write kt, then velocity is, k is constant, bring it outside, d by dt of t. I think you have remembered the relation, d by dx of constant is 0, d by dx of x to the power n is m into x to the power n minus 1. Power is n, bring power outside and subtract 1. Okay, then d by dt of t, power of t is 1, 1 is brought outside, then we have to subtract 1, power of t is 1, 1 minus 1, t to the power 0, 1, 1 into 1, 1, then velocity is equal to k means constant. So finally, we have to state the nature of motion. Velocity is constant, it means if displacement is directly proportional to time, then the body is moving with uniform velocity or constant velocity. Okay. Then bit B. In bit B, it's given displacement directly proportional to square of time. So we may write displacement is equal to a constant into square of time. See, time changes, so displacement changes, so velocity is produced. Let's first find velocity. Ds by dt, that's equals to d by dt of kt square. Then velocity, k is constant, bring it outside, d by dt of t square, power of t is 2, power of x is n, bring the power outside and subtract 1, means x to the power n minus 1. Similarly, here power of t is 2, bring power outside, then t to the power 2 minus 1 means t to the power 1. Then velocity is 2kt. This shows that 2k is constant, velocity directly proportional to time, since time always increases, velocity increases, so acceleration is produced. Let's find acceleration. Acceleration is dv by dt, then this equals to d by dt, v is 2kt, and acceleration is 2k is constant, d by dt of t is 1, as we have discussed previously, so acceleration is constant. So if displacement directly proportional to square of time, then the nature of motion is body is moving with uniform acceleration or constant acceleration. Okay, then bit C, we can solve it in similar way. Okay, bit C, displacement proportional to cube of time, then similarly displacement is equal to a constant into cube of time, So time changes, displacement changes, so velocity is produced, velocity is ds by dt, that's equals to d by dt of kt cube. So velocity, k is constant, bring it outside, d by dt of t cube, power is 3, bring the power outside and subtract 1. Okay, power is 3, bring power outside, then t to the power 3 minus 1 means t to the power 2, so velocity is 3k t square. Okay. Again, velocity is directly proportional to square of time. Okay. This also shows time changes, so velocity changes means acceleration is produced. So again, acceleration is dv by dt, dy dt of 3k t square. Then acceleration, 3k is constant, bring outside, dy dt of t square, power is 2, bring power outside and subtract 1. Okay. Then t to the power 2 minus 1 is t. Means acceleration is 3 into 2, 6, 6 kt. So acceleration is 6 kt. Okay. This shows that acceleration directly proportional to time. Since 6 k is constant, time increases, so acceleration increases. Thus, our conclusion, if displacement is directly proportional to cube of time, then the body is moving with increasing acceleration. Since time increases, acceleration increases. Okay, we are finding easier. Okay, then question number 4, you should take screenshot. Question number 4, question number 4, see students, displacement is given, we have to find instantaneous acceleration. Okay, displacement of a body along x-axis is given as x is equal to 6t cube minus 2t square, displacement is in meter, means x is in meter, where t is time, t is in second, so x in meter. Bt, find. First, let's find average acceleration, then we will calculate instantaneous acceleration. Find average acceleration between the intervals t1 is equal to 1 second and t2 is equal to 2 seconds. Then we find instantaneous acceleration at t is equal to any time you may take, 1 second, 2 second, 3 second, whatever you may take. Okay, then let's solve it. Displacement is given 6t cube minus 2t square, so time changes, displacement changes along x axis, so velocity is dx by dt, here displacement is x, so velocity is rate of change of displacement. Okay, then d by dt up 6t cube minus 2t square, so velocity d by dt of 6t cube, 6 is constant, bring 6 outside, then d by dt of t cube, okay, d by dx of x to the power n, d by dt of t cube, bring the power outside and subtract 1. Okay, then power of t is 3, power is brought outside, then t to the power 3 minus 1, subtract 1 means t square, minus d by dt of 2t square, 2 is constant, bring it outside, d by dt of t square, power is 2, bring power outside and subtract 1, t to the power 2 minus 1 is 1 means t. So velocity is 18t square minus 4t, we may take meter per second. Then we have to find vt, average acceleration between the interval of time 1 second and 2 seconds, say when time is t1, velocity is v1, time is t1 1 second, then velocity is v1 at 1 second, then v1 is 8 into 1 square minus 4 into 1, in place of t let's put 1, then this is equals to 18 minus 4, okay, this is equals to 14 meter per second, and final velocity v2 when time is 2 second, let's put in place of t 2 second, time 2 is t2 is 2 second. Okay, then velocity 18 t square, t is 2, 2 square, minus 4 into t means 4 into 2. So this comes 18 into 4, 72, okay, minus 4 into 2, 8, okay, so this comes 64 meter per second, okay. Then finally, average acceleration, magnitude of average acceleration, body is moving along a straight line, so we may directly calculate V2 minus V1 divided by delta t, okay. Delta t means we may take T2 minus T1 V2, 64 meter per second V1, 14 meter per second T2 minus T1 means 2 second minus 1 second, so this will come 50 meter per second square, okay. This is average acceleration between the interval of time 1 second and 2 second. Okay. Then between we have to find instantaneous acceleration at t is equal to 1 second. Can I erase it? Okay. Between instantaneous acceleration, as we know, magnitude of instantaneous acceleration is rate of change of velocity dv by dt of 18 t square minus 4 t. Okay. Then instantaneous acceleration d by dt of 18 t square, 18 is constant, bring it outside, d by dt of t square, power is 2, bring power outside and subtract 1, t to the power 2 minus 1 is 1 means t, minus d by dt of 4 t, 4 is constant, bring it outside and d by dt of t is 1, as we have discussed, so then it comes 18 into 2, okay, means 36t minus 4. So we have to find instantaneous acceleration when time is 1 second. Okay, then acceleration is 36 into 1 second minus 4. So answer is 32 meter per second square. So this is instantaneous acceleration at t is equal to 1 second. Okay. Then we'll move to question number 5. Okay. Question number 5. Here in question number 5, let's assume that body is moving on xy plane. Okay. Displacement along x-axis is given. Displacement along y-axis is given in terms of time t. Okay. Then we have to find acceleration. Okay. Means instantaneous acceleration, displacements are given as x is equal to, means displacement along x axis, okay, 70 plus 40 square meter, where x is in meter and t is in second, and y means displacement along y axis is given as 50 meter, okay. Then we have to find instantaneous acceleration at t is equal to 5 seconds. Okay. At any instant of time, we have to find instantaneous acceleration. So, displacement along x-axis is 70 plus 40 square. Then velocity along x-axis, since displacement changes, time changes, so velocity is produced. So velocity along x-axis, let's take dx, that's equals to dx by dt. Means rate of change of displacement along x-axis, that's equals to d by dt, x 70 plus 40 square. Then dx, d by dt of 70, 7 is constant, bring it outside and d by dt of t is 1. Plus d by dt of 40 square, 4 is constant, bring it outside, d by dt of t square, power is 2. Bring power outside and subtract 1. T to the power 2 minus 1 means T to the power 1 means T. So velocity along x-axis 7 plus 8T meter per second. Okay. So along x-axis, the relation shows that along x-axis velocity increases since T means time increases. Then displacement along y-axis is 5T. Okay. Then velocity along y-axis is dy by dt. Means d by dt of 5t, okay, so this is equals to 5 is constant, bring it outside and d by dt of t is 1, means velocity along y axis is 5 meter per second. See students, along y-axis velocity is constant 5. So along y-axis acceleration is 0. If velocity is constant, then acceleration is rate of change of velocity. Velocity doesn't change, which is constant. So acceleration along y-axis is 0. Okay. Then we have to get acceleration. Acceleration along x-axis, okay, that's equals to rate of change of velocity along x-axis. So acceleration along x-axis dy dt, velocity along x-axis is 7 plus 80. Then acceleration along x-axis dy dt of 7, 7 is constant, so differentiation of constant is 0. Dy dt of 80, 80 is constant, bring it outside, and dy dt of t is 1. So acceleration along x-axis is 8 meter per second square, and acceleration along y-axis is 0, since velocity along y-axis is constant. And final thought, resulting acceleration is equal to acceleration along x-axis plus acceleration along y-axis. So resulting acceleration is acceleration along x-axis is 8 plus acceleration along y-axis is 0. So resulting acceleration is 8 meter per second square. Obviously, resulting acceleration is directed along x-axis. Okay. This is about question number 5. Then question number 6. Taken concept? Okay. Question number 6, highly fundamental question, okay, and applicable in competitive exams, okay. Relation between position, let's take x, means motion is along x-axis, and time t is given as, t is equal to alpha x square plus beta x, where alpha and beta are constants. Okay. Alpha and beta are constant. X is position, means displacement, t is time. Then find acceleration of the body. Okay. We have to find acceleration, but the relation between time t and displacement, means position x, is given. So t is equal to alpha x square plus beta x. Let's first find dt by dx. Okay, then dy dx of t, in place of t we can write alpha x square plus beta x. So dt by dx is equal to dy dx of alpha x square, alpha is constant, bring it outside, and dy dx of x to the power 2, bring the power outside and subtract 1. So 2, x to the power 2 minus 1 means x to the power 1 means x, plus dy dx of beta x, beta is constant, bring it outside, and dy dx of x is 1, power x is 1, okay, x to the power 1, 1 into x to the power 1 minus 1 means 1, okay. Then dt by dx, what we get? 2 alpha x plus beta. So velocity is dx by dt. Okay. Then velocity is 1 divided by 2 alpha x plus beta. This is velocity. But we have to calculate acceleration. Okay. Then acceleration. Acceleration is rate of change of velocity, magnitude of acceleration. Okay. Motion is along a straight line, means along x-axis. So acceleration d by dt of v, in place of v we can write 1 divided by 2 alpha x plus beta. Okay. See students, we have to differentiate. Now see the method d by dt of 2 alpha x plus beta to the power minus 1. Okay. Let's first differentiate the whole 2 alpha x plus beta, then we will differentiate in steps 2 alpha x and beta. Okay. Then as we know, dy dx of x to the power n is n into x to the power n minus 1. Here n plus of n, we have got minus 1. So acceleration is n, means minus 1, into 2 alpha x plus beta. x to the power n minus 1, n is minus 1, minus 1. Okay. This is differentiation of whole. Then we have to differentiate again 2 alpha x and beta in d by dt of 2 alpha x. Then d by dt of beta is 0 because beta is constant only. D by dt of 2 alpha x. Then acceleration is minus 1 into 2 alpha x, sorry, plus beta to the power minus 2, d by dt of 2 alpha x, this is 2 alpha, 2 alpha is constant, bring it outside, then dx by dt. I think it's not clear to you, I'm writing here, okay. Acceleration is minus 1, this step, 2 alpha x plus beta to the power minus 1, minus 1, n minus 1 into d by dt of 2 alpha x, okay. Then d by dt of beta is 0 because beta is constant. So acceleration is minus 1 into 2 alpha x plus beta whole to the power minus 2. Again d by dt of 2 alpha x, 2 alpha is constant, bring it outside. Then d by dt of x means dx by dt, okay. Then next step, acceleration is minus 1 divided by 2 alpha x plus beta whole square minus 2, then this is power 2, then 2 alpha dx by dt, we may write v, okay. Then acceleration is minus 1 divided by 2 alpha x plus beta whole square into, I may write here 2 alpha into velocity, velocity as we got 1 divided by 2 alpha x plus beta. Then acceleration is minus 2 alpha divided by 2 alpha x plus beta whole cube. And again we know velocity is 1 divided by 2 alpha x plus beta. Then acceleration is minus 2 alpha. 1 by 2 alpha x plus beta is velocity. Cube means 2 alpha v cube. So here acceleration is expressed in terms of velocity. It must be mentioned in the question. Find acceleration in terms of velocity v. Okay. So it is asked to calculate acceleration, but we have got acceleration but negative, means this is a retardation. Okay. If velocity increases, then acceleration is positive. If velocity decreases, then acceleration is negative. So negative means retardation or deceleration. Question number 7. A point moves along a straight line with retardation, which depends on velocity as beta is equal to a root v, where a is constant, means here beta is retardation and v is velocity. Okay. If initial velocity is v naught, then we have to find what is distance traveled by it before coming to rest. Okay. Then let's come to answer. Okay. As we have discussed, acceleration may be calculated as change in velocity with respect to change in time, or acceleration is calculated as change in velocity with respect to change in displacement. Here we will calculate, means method of acceleration, calculation of acceleration is change in velocity with respect to change in displacement. See students, we have already discussed it. Acceleration, magnitude of acceleration is dv by dt. Let's multiply 1, means ds by ds 1. Okay. And again dv by dt. Then ds by dt. Ds by dt is v. Then dv by ds. Okay. So change in velocity with respect to change in displacement. I am writing here relation of acceleration v dv by ds. Okay. We'll use this in this case. So after practicing a lot of questions, you can estimate that what type of relation we'll use. Okay. So acceleration is beta is given as a root v, but here it is retardation, so you may take negative. Okay. Acceleration positive, retardation is negative. Okay. Then retardation is V, dV by dS, okay, negative we have already taken, minus A, root of V, A is constant, okay. Then we have to find distance travel, okay.
If a body is moving along a straight line, then magnitude of displacement is same as that of distance.
Then dS is equal to V, dV, we may take minus dS is equal to V, dV, divided by A, root V. Then it comes 1 by A root V into dV. Then this is dS. Now, to get displacement, we have to integrate both sides, minus integration of dS, 1 by A. See, A is constant, 1 by A is constant, integration of square root of V into dV. Then, we have to take limit, initial velocity is V naught. Before coming to rest, means final velocity is 0, initial displacement left 0, final displacement is S.
I think you have remembered the fundamental formula of integration. Integration of dx is x, integration of x to the power n into dx is x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. Okay.
Then integration of ds, we may take S minus limit is from 0 to S. 1 by A. See students, here I am taking one other step. 1 by A. Integration of square root of V, limit is V naught to 0, V to the power 1 by 2 into dV.
Now it is easier. X to the power N into dx, V to the power 1 by 2 into dV. The relation means x to the power n into dx, integration of x to the power n into dx is x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1.
So 1 by a. Result of integration, v to the power 1 by 2 plus 1, x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1, 1 by 2 plus 1, limit is from v naught to 0. So this is, we may take another row, let's complete this line, minus s minus 0, upper limit minus lower limit, 1 by a, v to the power 3 by 2 divided by 3 by 2, limit is from v naught to 0. Okay.
Then, I am erasing the top lines.
Okay. Then, this comes minus s, and that's equals to 1 by a, 2 by 3, means 3 by 2 becomes 2 by 3. A. 3 by 2, 2 by 3 into. Let's put the limits V to the power 3 by 2 means 0 to the power 3 by 2 0. Then minus V naught to the power 3 by 2. Then minus S means displacement is 2 by 3 into minus V naught to the power 3 by 2. And our final answer is S means this distance traveled along a straight line. Okay. Then magnitude of displacement is 2 by 3 into V naught to the power 3 by 2. This is our answer. Okay. I think you are accepting well. Okay. So this is the answer. Next question. Then question number 8. Question number 8. A point traverses on a circular track with uniform speed. With uniform speed, let speed is 36 meter per second and completes one revolution in easier than 36 seconds. Okay, the particle completes one revolution, means once around the circular track it moved, completed in 36 seconds, but speed is constant. Okay,
Then what we have to find, we'll see it later. See, suppose a particle is moving along a circle with constant speed, as we have discussed. If a particle or body moves along a curved path, then direction of motion changes at every instant of motion. Okay, though speed remains constant, but velocity doesn't remain constant. Velocity at any instant means direction of velocity at any instant can be determined by drawing a tangent at the required position. At this position, this is direction of velocity. At this position, this is direction of velocity. At this position, this is direction of velocity, and so on. But magnitude of V1 is equal to magnitude of V2 is equal to magnitude of V3, that is equals to speed. Means magnitude of velocity is constant. Okay. Then question is given, find acceleration if it completes a semi-circular track. Completes a semicircle. Simple. Semicircle. Bit B. Find acceleration if it completes a quarter circle, and so on. Okay. Let's understand the fundamental. Okay. Suppose a body moves or a particle traverses along the circular path. Let it starts from A. Here, let velocity is V1, reaches at B. For A bit, here velocity is V2. Okay. Then it completes a semicircle moving from A to B. Then obviously angle produced at the center is pi or 180 degree. Okay, for bit B, let the particle starts from position A and reaches at position B, means completes a quarter circle. Here speed is all cases constant, and to complete the quarter circle, angle produced at the center is 90 degree. Means for semicircular track, angle produced at the center is 180 degree. For quarter circular path, angle produced at the center is 90 degree. So if we stick an angle, then for any value of angle, 180 degree, 90 degree, 60 degree, 120 degree, one per minute. Okay. I think we have discussed it earlier when we are discussing about the numericals on distance and displacement, or speed and velocity. This type of questions are given. Okay. Then here, angle between V1 and V2 is 180 degree, and here, let at A, velocity is V1, at B, velocity is V2. Then here, angle between V1 and V2 is 90 degree. Okay. Let for any angle, let angle between V1 and V2 is theta. Acceleration is rate of change of velocity. Okay. Then change in velocity means delta V. We may take V2 minus V1 or V2 plus minus V1. So magnitude of change in velocity, we may take, as we have discussed, square root of V2 square plus V1 square plus 2V1 V2 cos 180 minus theta. This is the method. Then change in velocity is square root of, here speed is constant, means magnitude of V1 is equal to magnitude of V2 is equal to V, which is speed. Then square root of V square plus V square plus 2V into V, V square into cos 180 minus theta is minus cos theta. Then V square plus V square, 2V square. 2V square is bracket common. Then 1 minus cos theta square root. Again we know 2V square into 1 minus cos theta. 1 minus cos theta may be taken as 2 sine square theta by 2. Then magnitude of change in velocity is 2 into 2, 4. Square root is 2. V square, square root V. Sine square theta by 2. Sine theta by 2. This is your form how to change in velocity, how to calculate change in velocity for any angle theta, means theta is angle between initial and final velocity. I am writing here
magnitude of change in velocity is 2 v sine theta by 2.
Okay. Can I erase it? Okay.
Then about time, since the body or particle or point moves around the circle with constant speed, then it covers equal distance in equal interval of time. Total time taken is 36 seconds, means the body starts from A, again reaches at A. Total path is completed in 36 seconds, means for one complete revolution, angle produced at the center is 360 degrees. Okay. For this total angle, time is 36 seconds. Okay. Then A bit. Third acceleration, if it completes a semicircular path. Okay. Then acceleration, magnitude of acceleration is change in velocity divided by change in time. Change in velocity 2V sine theta for semicircle. Angle is 180 degree divided by 2 sine theta by 2 divided by change in time. See, for one complete revolution, time is 36 seconds. For half revolution, means for semicircular track, obviously time is T by 2. Since speed is constant, so time is 18 seconds. Okay. Then acceleration is 2V. Speed is constant, 36. 2 into 36. Sin 180 degree by 2 means sin 90 is 1 divided by 18 second. So this comes to into 2 4 meter per second square. And accordingly, for bit B, you may take magnitude of acceleration, change in velocity 2V sin. For 1 quarter revolution, angle is 90, sin 90 divided by 2 divided by change in time delta t. For 1/4 revolution, time is 1/4. For half revolution, time is half, 36 by 2, 18 seconds. For 1/4 revolution, time is 9 seconds. Now you can calculate sine 45, 1 by root 2, and b is 36 meter per second for any angle. You can calculate, since speed is constant, for 360 degree, time is 36 seconds. If it were given for 60 degree, subtends an angle 60 degree above the center, then for 60 degree you can calculate 1/6. Okay. And for 120 degree, 1/3 of time. Okay. Then it is easier, the only one format. Okay. Then last question, question number 9. Question number 9. Okay. Acceleration of a body is given as A is equal to acceleration depends upon time. So acceleration in terms of time is given as 3t square plus 2t plus 2. We may take in meter per second square. Okay. Again, it's given in the question if initial velocity is 2 meter per second, what is velocity of the body? Okay, what is velocity of the body at the end of 2 seconds? Means starting from 0 second, initial time we may take 0, at the end of 2 seconds we have to find velocity of the body. Okay, then initial velocity is 2 meter per second. When time is 0, we have to find velocity when time is 2 seconds. Then acceleration is given as 3t square plus 2t plus 2. Then acceleration is very simple question. dv by dt is equal to 3t square plus 2t plus 2. Simple integration. Then dv is equal to 3t square plus 2t plus 2 into dt. Then now integrate both sides. dv. See, initial velocity 2 meter per second, lower limit. Final velocity, let take v. Okay. Then integration of 3t square plus 2t plus 2 into dt. Okay. This is time. Initial time we may take 0. Final time is 2 seconds. Now you can do it. It is made easier now. Only integration. Integration of dv is v. The limit is from 2 meter per second to final velocity v, then integration of 3t square dt. Okay, as per rule of integration, x to the power n dx, x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1, 3 is constant, bring it outside. Then integration of t square dt means t square, power of t is 2, n is 2, then t to the power 2 plus 1, 3 divided by 2 plus 1, 3. Okay. Then plus integration of 2t into dt, 2 is constant, bring it outside, and power of t is 1, power of x is n. Then t to the power 1 plus 1 means t square divided by 1 plus 1, 2. Okay. Then integration of 2 into dt, 2 is constant, bring it outside, and integration of dt is t, since integration of dx is x, so this is t. And we may take limit from 0 to 2 second. Okay. Now final velocity is v minus, putting higher limit, upper limit v minus lower limit 2, 3, 3 get cancelled, 2, 2 get cancelled. So t cube, put first upper limit 2 cube minus 0, 0 cube, okay, plus t square, first let's put upper limit 2 square in place of t 2 minus in place of t 0, 0 square 0, plus 2 into t in place of t, let's put first upper limit minus t is 0. Now we can calculate. I am doing here for clarity. Okay, then v minus 2 is equal to 2 cube means 8 minus 0 plus 2 square means 4 plus 2 into 2 again 4. So v minus 2 is 4 plus 4 8, 8 plus 8 16. So final velocity 16 plus 2 means 18 meter per second. This is our answer. See students, this class means lecture 7, we have discussed some fundamental numericals on different types of acceleration. Okay, and as we have discussed from the beginning of the class, these are some basic questions, and I hope all these questions you have enjoyed the how to find the answer of the questions. And again, I can assure you, this will make your fundamental to practice more and more numericals. Okay, thank you.